name is Alyssa Cleland. I am a 22-year-old here in Dallas, Texas. We're at a private facility right now that I currently lease a horse at. When I was six, I just always kind of loved horses. I got lessons from my parents, and so I started riding, just kind of fell in love with it. I've had some difficulties with my prosthetic just because certain facilities saw me as too much of a liability, and so they didn't want me training there. I kind of fell out of it, and then when I moved to Oklahoma for college, Oklahoma's a very like agricultural state. I got to ride a lot of like my friends' horses and kind of get back into it, which was great. I found out about paradressage, all that was kind of happening in Texas, and that's kind of how I ended up here. And so I've trained with a few different trainers and just kind of had like lesson horses that I rode. I did show a little bit, went to regional championships. I kind of found my way to my lease horse now because I was like ready to like not really own a horse yet because like that's expensive and like I don't have enough money. My new lease horse is a 16-year-old 16-2 Morgan Sport horse. He is just so freaking adorable. I can't even handle it. He's a little bit of like a grumpykin because like he's a little girthy and he likes to put his ears back, but don't let that fool you. He is actually a jumper and low level dressage horse. He did jumping a lot throughout his life, but he kind of isn't really like into it right now, so it's just not really like filling his horsey needs or wants. They switched him over to dressage and he loves it. He's not spooky or anything. We have like cows and wind and he couldn't care less, so that's great for me because I've definitely had those horses where I've been thrown off and it's not fun, especially when you only have one leg. So for right now, for like the immediate future, I guess just kind of get more saddle time. At the old place I was at, I was only riding like once a week, which I mean, if that's the situation you're in, more power to you. The more time you get, the better. But I wasn't really feeling like I was getting anywhere in my training. And so with this lease horse, I'm gonna ride 3 to 4 times a week and then eventually start working with a trainer to start progressing him. I mean, I don't see us going, you know, to like Grand Prix or anything. And I'm not really looking to show at the moment just because money, time, all that stuff. But obviously, you know, if I somehow win the lottery or get some, you know, awesome sponsors or whatever, that's definitely in my future. But for the long term, I'd really love to own a horse of my own and, you know, make it to the Paralympics someday. That would just be so amazing. But obviously that takes a lot of work. And, you know, I think I'm doing the next right thing and getting the lease horse and just, you know, getting more time in the saddle, because more time in the saddle just means more experience for me and, you know, more experience riding horses. So I'm good with it. So what I do on social media is just kind of share my journey and my story as an amputee, as a paradressage rider, as someone in the disabled community. Disabled people kind of in general, I feel, are so overlooked and, you know, underrepresented. And so I really just want to be a positive role model and a voice for the disabled community and just show like, you know, like, hey, like, I can do this, you can do this, it doesn't matter what limbs you're missing or whatever, like anything is possible. And just to show that, like, you know, you don't have to have like two legs to do what you want to do. So with my little platform, this is gonna sound so stupid, I want to be Instagram famous. No shame. But honestly, with platforms like Instagram and like YouTube, your following has so much leverage as you grow it. And so I know that in order to like, not that I'm not making an impact right now, but I know that if I want to make like a big impact and be able to help charities, help veterans, help, you know, people that just lost their limb, like I have to have a following, and so that way I can use my following for good. So that's kind of what I'm doing my platform right now, just share my little journey and just, you know, trying to spread some positivity to the equestrian world. I would tell them that's going to be really, really hard. And you're gonna wanna quit a lot. And there's gonna be a lot of people that you will compare yourself to, like, oh, she has this really nice horse. Oh, this person has two legs. Oh, this person has more money than me. And it's not like you can't compare yourself to those people. Like, you are gonna compare yourself to those people. And so you just gotta get in that mindset that like, hey, that's okay. My situation might be a little like shitty, but you know, I just gotta keep pushing forward, keep doing it. Eventually the right people are gonna see what you're doing and they're gonna be in your corner. And that's what you need to help you grow as a person, as a writer. It's gonna be hard, you can do it, it's gonna take time. It's not all gonna happen tomorrow, even though you really want it to. Just kind of like enjoy the journey. With Raleigh and all that stuff, I've been like dreaming for this moment for so long. And it's so funny because I like look back, I just kind of see like how everything I did led up to this moment, and I wouldn't have appreciated this moment as much if I didn't go through everything that I had to go through. And as sucky as it had been, you know, it's all part of my story, and now I just get to like share that and relate to other people that have gone through the same thing as me. And so it's gonna suck, but it's gonna be worth it in the end. So, you know, 5-10 years, look back on your life and just see how far you've come. I mean, it's amazing what we can do when we put our focus into our passion. I have a podcast, it's called Horsing Around with Alyssa. I started it at the beginning of this year and I'm really, really proud of it, and I have really cool people on it. Y'all need to listen to it and go follow my little Instagram right here. She's gonna edit it for it to say at Horsing Around with Alyssa, I just know it. So go follow. It's just a way to, again, bring some positivity to the world. And on my podcast, I do some solo episodes to kind of explain my life and my situation, but then I also bring on people with disabilities, people with diseases, anything that people are going through, just to kind of showcase like, hey, this person has this, but they did this, 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 like how cool are they? I really love my podcast, obviously I made it, so go check it out.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching our first influencer interview on Cowgirl Crossing. We have so much more exciting content coming your way, so hit subscribe and we'll see you next time.